I greet you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Today I want to talk about 10 types of pride. But for me, I will say pride is pride, but I will explain to you. So I shall start my readings to Proverbs 27, verse 1. Do not boast about tomorrow, for you do not know what a day may bring forth. I will explain this later. Number one, first, pride. Pride of intellect. Do not able to listen. You are not able to listen to each other. You are very boastful, unwilling to learn. Or even you don't listen to God. You know, if you don't listen to God, it's a part of a pride. It's a pride. If you don't listen to God, it's a part of a pride. You are like an atheist. Atheists, they don't believe that there's God. They don't listen to God. Atheist. Number two, pride of superiority. Pride of superiority. You are very difficult to deal with. You lie too much. Number three, pride of independent. Not interested with others. Or even in your church, you say you have the very best people. You are the very best church. You criticize other churches. Like you say we have got a true gospel. Those others, they don't have a true gospel. That's the pride of independent. Number four, pride of ambition. You desire for position too much. Honor, fame, accusing others, criticizing other people. Number five, pride of sensitiveness. Small things, you'll be offended, easily to be irritated. The way you walk with a pride. Number six, pride of diminity. Afraid of your post to be taken. You like post too much. You want people to praise you. All the glory must be to you. Number seven, pride of timidity. You don't stand for the truth. Number eight, pride of scrupulosity. Attention of wrong things. You want to be right always. That's a part of pride. Things for looking for a problem to accuse other people. It caused the pride. Number nine, pride of vanity. You want to be at first places, superiority. Number 10, pride of humility. It's similar to spiritual pride. Pretending to be humble. You think you are the best, which means this is pride. We are talking of arrogance, boastful, high-minded, inflate. We are talking of pride. When we are talking of pride, and remember, let me go to another scripture. Luke 18, verse 9. It says, also he spoke this parable to some who trusted in themselves that they were righteous and despised others. If you have that mindset of despising others, which means you have got a pride in you. You always think that you are holy, and you accuse people that you are not holy. You are fornicators. You commit adultery. You witches. You people. You refuse the law. Whatever. It is a lot of things. When you have got a pride, you despise a lot of people. You take yourself as you are very, very, very highly. And superiority for yourself. And you are better than other people when you have pride. You don't listen to other people. I will continue with this verse. I will continue. 10 verse. Two men went up to the to temple to pray, one a Pharisee and other a tax collector. The Pharisees stood and prayed thus with him: God, I thank you that I am not like the man. You see, he's praising himself. All the glory to him. You see, you know, when pride comes to you, it will bring you down. Remember, this is he went before the God. Now he's praising himself. That you praise yourself. Let me take it this way. You praise yourself. That I pray too much. I'm more than anyone else. I preach too much. I'm more than anyone else. I fast too much. You are more than anyone else. You despise others. You sing better than anyone else. When you are not there, the service will not go on. When you are not there, no one can preach. When you are not there, no one can sing. No one can prophesy. You take all the honor, all the glory to you. Why? What's going on? Because you have created pride. The foundation of pride is Satan. You know, Satan is a liar. Satan is the founder of all evil. So you must repent from pride. A lot of people, they don't believe that they've got a pride in themselves. Remember that king of Babylon, Nebuchadnezzar. He was a king who was ruling a country. And Daniel told him that, King, you must repent to your sin, to your wicked, your transgressions. He refused. But there comes a day when he says, all this city is built because of me. You know what happened? God beat him. God beat him. When God beat him, his nails was long like an animal, and God gave him a heart of an animal. Why? Because he didn't listen to God. He didn't refuse to repent. So you must repent. When God humbled that King Nebuchadnezzar, how about you? Who are you? He can humble you too. So, remove pride in your life. Remove pride. Pride is very bad. I will continue with this verse. And just adulterers or even as these tax collectors. You see now, he's saying people, they are unjust adulterers. You see, if you have got a prize, you accuse people of sinning. And you take yourself as you are holy. Who told you that you are holy? Jesus must tell you that you are holy. Remove pride in you. Remove pride in you. Pride is a disease. If you don't accept that you have got a pride, you won't see it. And a lot of people, they don't accept that they've got a pride. 12 verse, it says, I fast twice a week. Fast is not a problem. But the way you present it, what is in your heart? I give tithe to all that I possesses. He said, I give tithe. He said, the work of God is moving because of me. You see now, he said, I'm the one who is supporting this church. I'm the one who is paying a lot of money. No, paying money is not bad. You know, the Bible said, if you give with right, let left not see. Which means you must not praise yourself. Remove that pride. Remove that pride in you. Yes. And the tax collector, standing after off, and will not so much as raise him his eyes to heaven, but beat his breast, saying, God, be merciful to me, a sinner. You see, he's humble himself to God. Those who humble themselves, God will raise them. I tell you, this man went down to his house, justified rather, will be humbled, and he who humble himself will be exalted. So just remember, are you not walking in pride? Ask yourself, do you agree that you have got a pride? You want, when you have a pride, you want all the glory to come to you. When pride is in you, you bring other people's down. You bring other people's down. Character of a pride brings others down. When you have got a pride, you bring others down. You say, I am the man. I am the man. When I am not there, nothing will move on. Self-centered. Self-centered. When you have a pride, self-love. You don't love other people when you have a pride. You know, when you have a pride, it blinds your mind. It blinds your mind, your understanding. You won't even understand. Highly think of yourself. And self-centered, you think of yourself that you are best to other people. Moving independent, you don't want to be with other people. You move independent. You see now, without God, because when you have got God, you don't have a pride. You humble yourself. Opposite of a pride, it's humble. Opposite of a pride, it's humble. So when you have got a pride, which means you don't have the word of God. You know, that's why you see a lot of people, they say, I am a better preacher, or I'm the only true gospel. I'm the only true who is preaching true gospel. I'm the only who is a better singer. Why is it like that? You have got a pride. You don't listen to other people's when you have got pride. You don't listen to anyone because you say you know everything. You have got a full of I know, and you reduce people. When you have got a pride, you have got that sense of unwilling to learn. You have got that sense of unwilling to learn. You don't listen to other people or even to God, because when you listen to God, you humble yourself. When you listen to God, you humble yourself. The Bible said about Moses, when he was on his way going to Canaan, they were in desert and people were thirst. And they were crying and they wanted to stone Moses. And they said to Moses, we want water. Why you take us? You took us from Egypt. And Moses went before the Lord. But God said to Moses, take that staff you have got, that rod, and go and beat that rock. And Moses went there and said, you people of unbelief, we want to give you water. You know Moses, he irritated God. He did not arrive in Canaan because of pride. Moses, look at the position of Moses. Moses is the founder of the Old Testament, the covenant, the Old Covenant. And Moses, God loved him, but at last he used pride. He used pride. And God said, you are not going to Canaan, a promised land. He didn't go there. Why? Because of pride. You know, when pride, if you've got a pride, it drops you down. And pride, it leads you to destruction. And pride, you want people to praise you. Pride in business. There are people who say, I've got my own money. You know, in pride, if you say, I've got my own money, I've got my own life, I'm beautiful, I'm educated. You know, whatever you are possessed is because of God. Whatever talent you have got, it's because of God. So you must remove pride in you. If pride comes to you, you are very complicated to deal with. If pride comes to you, you are very complicated to deal with, because you have got a pride. You don't listen to people. You praise yourself. You praise yourself. You are what you are today because God made you that. You have got money, you have got business, because God did that for you. You are a pastor, you are an apostle. God did it for you. Don't praise yourself. This is the glory of God. But you want the glory of God to be in you. You want the glory of God to be in you. There are other people who praise themselves because of this life. They praise themselves because of this life. They are rich. They say, I'm educated. You other people, they are not educated. You are educated because it's God. God gave you that wisdom. God gave you that knowledge. It's not you are very clever. There are people who were clever, but they didn't have the money to go to university, to colleges. But so don't say, uneducated people, you've got a problem. You see, if you've got a pride, people they can't help you because you look down for them. You praise yourself. So be very careful. A lot of people, they don't accept that they've got a pride. They've got a pride. Your life is too small. Our life is too small. So we must repent to all types of sin. If you have got a pride, you don't accept any person to cancel you. You desire position too much if you have got a pride. You desire positions too much because you want people to praise you. If those positions, they come in good way, which is good. When God says, you know, there are people who say, I will do it as a pastor, but God never called you as a pastor, as a teacher, as an apostle. You never heard God telling you that you are an apostle, you are a pastor. You see now, what is causing you? It's a pride. It's a pride. Remove pride. It's destroying church. It's destroying the body of Christ with pride. You desire people, positions, fame. What is that? To be the best hired, highly. And you will accuse people when you have got pride. When you've got pride, angry to be needed, you want people too much to look for you. So pride is a very bad thing in your life. Pride is very bad thing in your life. Stay away from pride. You see, it doesn't matter. It's in family. Say, you didn't come to me and invite me. You see, let us have that mind which was in Christ. Although he was God, he didn't take that as is similar to who? To God. So when you have pride, you don't respect people. When you have pride, you don't respect people. You disregard people. The way you walk, the way you talk, it's pride. So stay away from pride. It's very bad. Focus on God. Focus on God. Humble yourself. Afraid of God. You see now. So, a lot of people, they don't agree that you have got a pride. So, if you have got pride, it's very difficult to correct you. It's very difficult to correct. You know, there are people who are supposed to be builder now, but they are not builder. Why is it like that? Because of pride. You are assisting, but you were asking a lot of money. You were supposed to be a builder because of a pride. You were supposed to be a painter because of a pride. You were assisted. You know that you know nothing. You see, when you know nothing, which means you must learn. A lot of people, they are not learning the work of hands. Why? Because they've got pride. They've got pride. Pride, I'm talking of arrogance. Self-centered, high-minded, high-minded, in flat. You disregard the people. You don't have respect in you when you have got a pride. Whatever you possess is because of God. You make money because of God. You are a millionaire because of God. Whatever you possess, humble yourself. Humble yourself. Humble yourself. Jesus loves you. If you have got a pride, you don't forgive people. You don't forgive people. Self-sufficient. It's for you only. Or if you help people, you praise yourself that I help these poor. I help these poor. You disregard other people. You disregard other people. You don't consider other people. You are not teachable. You are unteachable. You rebuke other people. You defend yourself. You are defensive. Negative respect. That is disregarding other people. Disrespecting other people. Looking people down. You always find faults. When you have got pride to reduce other people. So we are saying possess humility. You must humble yourself before the Lord. God loves people who humble themselves. The Bible says if you are invited to any feast, you must sit at the back, the chairs at the back. Don't go in front. So when you humble yourself, you forgive people, you love people, you don't elevate yourself. If you have got a pride, you elevate yourself. You elevate yourself. So, which means there's no Holy Spirit in you. You must repent from this disease of pride. It's a disease. It's a disease. So pride was the source of the destruction of Lucifer. Pride was the source of the destruction of Lucifer. Why he had got a rebellious to God? Because Satan was possessing pride. He wanted to be like God. He wanted to be like God. Like now, you can see he always imitates God. So when you have pride, it drives you away from people. And if you've got pride, you are impatient. God hates pride. That is the main thing. Pride leads to destruction. Evil life expires. So be very careful with evil life. It's going to expire. But if you humble yourself, if you walk in the Lord, if you carry the cross of Jesus, you will go to eternity. You will have an everlasting life. You will have an everlasting life. Pride leads you to destruction. And you will lose a lot of opportunity. And the pride, it's an idolatry. You know, idolatry, it's when you are in sinful nature. So God is renovating your heart. When you have got a pride, you prove the point. You prove the point. You don't want to be wrong. You don't want to be wrong. My last scripture is James 4. My last scripture, verse 13. James 4, verse 13. This is my last scripture. Come now. Who say, today or tomorrow, we will. And go search as a city. Spend a year there. Buy and sell and make profit. You say, whenever you want to do anything else, you must say, when God allows me. Don't say, tomorrow I want to do this. Here in the Bible, it shows that it's a pride. When you say you want to do this, you want to do this. You must say, when God allows, I want to do this. 14 verse, it says, wherever, what is your life? It is even vapor that appears for a little time and then vanishes away. Everything what we do is going to vanish. Instead, you ought to say, if the Lord wills, we shall live and do this is all that. But now, you boast in your arrogance. As such, boasting is evil. You boast in your arrogance, and boasting is evil. Therefore, to him who knows to do good and do not do it, to him it is sin. So this is my last verse. This is my last verse. I will say, you must repent from pride. Or even ladies, the Bible says, submit yourself from your husband. If you don't submit yourself, which means you've got an arrogance, it causes problems. That's why you see problems in marriages, because of pride. A lot of people, they've got a pride. A lot of people, they've got a pride in marriages because she don't want to submit yourself. Or even you are a husband, you don't submit yourself to God. If you don't submit yourself to God, which means you've got a pride. So we are saying, repent. This is sin, it's a disease. Thank you so much for watching this. Don't forget to subscribe for more teachings. I thank you so much. God bless you. Stay away from pride. Thank you so much. I will come with the other ceremony. You must ring a bell. Then if you ring a bell, you get the notification, which means you must subscribe to my channel for more teachings. I thank you so much. Repent from the spirit of pride. Thank you so much. Amen.